This here is AI. So is this. So in the short amount of time that we've been generating AI images, the technology has really progressed. So let's jump in and have a look at some of the functionality and the features in CG Dream. Okay, let's have a look at CG Dream AI. It's a web-based AI tool that generates images from text descriptions, images, or 3D models. It features the advanced Flux model for high quality and accurate visuals, ensuring precision even with complex prompts. The platform offers AI tools like Dolores styles, inpainting, upscaling, 3D to image, transfer style and structure. It makes it ideal for designers, marketers, content creators, and creative professionals. So let's dig in and have a look right now. So the Flux model is the new model that everybody's talking about. It's just generating incredibly realistic images that just look like photographs. And it also has the ability to even generate text and accurate anatomy now. So what we're going to do is we're going to start with just a quick text to image, but then we're going to dig into the filters because these LoRa filters really make a huge difference. So let's do a simple text to image. We're going to add it into the prompt here, and then we're just going to generate it right now. Notice because we set this variant to 2, we're going to get 2 variations. We could go up to 4 on the paid subscription, or the free subscription you can do up to 2. We can also change the aspect ratio here. And here's also where we're choosing the model. We're going to be using the Flux. Flux is the latest thing that everybody's getting really excited about because it's just so realistic. All right, so here's a couple of houses that are generated. Why don't we start with this particular one here, and now we're going to add some filters. So let's click on the filters, and you'll notice that there's a number of filters here. So what it's going to do is, at the top here, it's going to suggest filters that match the image prompt. So we're going to do an ivy and vines, we're going to do a moss, we're going to do a forest. And then why don't we just break it up a little bit, we'll do a scratched and worn. So let me just search for that one. So notice when we do that, we can search for different types of filters in here, and we're going to add a scratched and worn. All right, now we're able to add up to 5 filters per prompt, and we can go in and adjust how much these different prompts are going to influence the image. So maybe we don't want it as a scratched and worn. We could pull it back a little bit. And as you can see, we can just control the amount or the influence that each one of these filters have on the image. All right, let's generate this again. But this time, why don't we just go for a single variant just to keep things simple? And you can see here how the filters are really helping us get an even more realistic image. Now, we have the ability to add to this prompt by using the Dream Up feature. So if we click on here, the Dream Up is actually going to add to that prompt and create a new variation. And if we look at this, the Dream Up has really enhanced this image by enhancing the prompt. And you click and we can see, look at this. So Dream Up has added all of this to our prompt to create a much more visually striking image. So let's have a look at this. So if we zoom in on the image here, we also have the ability to up res. So if we hit the X2, we're now going to increase the image resolution. But this doesn't just increase the resolution, it also increases the amount of detail that we're seeing in the image here. All right, look at this amount of detail here in this house. So let's zoom in a little bit. So we've got this. So if we turn off the upscale and then turn it on, you can see, let's zoom in even more. So you can really see where it's enhancing that detail. Here it is before without it, and then including it. And if you want to download the image, you're just going to click on the download option. And right here, we get a PNG image. And you can see because of the Flux model, it just has the highest level of realism that's available today. So one of the things you might have noticed here is a private button. So with any of the paid subscriptions, everything you generate is for your eyes only. No one else is looking at it. It's private and also it's ready for commercial use. So one of the things we can do is a 3D to image. So let's do that right now. So we're going to search, we'll look for a castle. And why don't we use this castle right here? So we're just going to click on this and it's going to bring up a 3D model. So the nice thing about this is we compose it how we want it, but then we can also add our prompt. So I'm going to put in this prompt here. And why don't we get rid of these filters and we'll add some new filters in here. Let's do some fairy tales and some surrealistic. Okay, so we're going to add these filters and let's generate. You can change the strength of how much it's going to influence the image. The other thing we can do, of course, is we can upload our own 3D models if we want to use those. And then there's another option where we can take an image and convert it to a 3D model right here inside of CG Dream, and we'll look at that in a moment. All right, and look at this. We get a really cool variation there. Let's look at style and structure transfer. So why don't we create an image first? We're going to just create a car in a cyberpunk city. And let me change these filters to maybe something a little more interesting for the cars. We'll do a concept car, sci-fi car. Let's do a little luxury sports car. Sounds good. Let's generate this. Okay, for style, we're going to browse. I'm going to grab this image here, which was also generated in CG Dream. And I'm going to use that as a style influence. So it's not going to try to make it a woman. What it's going to do is it's going to take the style, the colors and everything from that. So as you can see, we've got this really cool looking car that is taking that style from the style reference. Okay, let's look at structure reference. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to clear this out of here. And let's generate a wizard performing on stage, curtains on the side. Let's get rid of these filters and get more appropriate filters. And we'll just keep it at these two for now. And let's generate. All right, that looks really cool. But what if we wanted a different pose? We can influence the pose by using a structural reference. Let me show you what I mean. Let's load in a structural reference right now. Use this one here. So this is going to influence the pose and the way the character looks in the image. We're going to keep the strength quite high. We'll use the same prompt and we'll use the same filters. The only difference here is the structural reference now. And we're going to hit generate. All right, and if you look at the result, notice that the pose is very similar to what we use for our structural reference. So as you can see, by using the, you know, the style and structure references, it really gives us a lot of creative freedom to create and generate what we want. Okay, now I want to show how we can do an image to 3D and then back to an image. So we have this image of a radio and I want to turn it into a 3D model. So we're going to click here on the 3D. It's not going to be a highly detailed model, but it doesn't need to be because what we essentially want to do is to be able to pose it. So if we click on it here, we're able to drag it around and position it. So imagine this when you're in Photoshop and you wanted to create props maybe, and you want to generate something, but you wanted a particular angle. You even wanted a particular field of view. We can change that by zooming in and out. And you can see we've got some different tools here for the ground and different things to move it around, walk around it. So we're going to put it in this position here. But now what I want to do is I want to generate a different type of radio based off this reference. So we're going to add a prompt here. Rusty old radio in an abandoned environment. Let's add some filters. These LoRa filters really make a huge difference. Let's do scratched and worn. Let's do rusty. And let's also do mossy. So we're just going to type in moss here. And there we go. We've got moss. And so based on this positioning with the 3D model, as a reference with this text and these filters, now we're going to generate our radio. And look at that. So amazingly real. I love it. All right, let's do one final one. We're going to go into the gallery and let's grab an image and let's modify it. And I'm going to grab this one that I found in the gallery. We're just loading it up right now. And I'm going to put a description in here. And this description came from DreamUp, so it was expanded. And then we're going to put some filters on it. All right, let's alter the strength. Let's turn the strength down a little bit. And we're going to generate. And look at that. That's a really cool looking image. And of course, we can increase the resolution on it. And I think it'd be fun just to generate four variations of this and see what we get. All right, we can see we've got some different variations there. Wow. So we've got that one. So we've got kind of a darker, more maleficent kind of looking. This one's really interesting. And then this one here is more angelic. And by the way, this video is sponsored by CG Dream. CG Dream have just enhanced their service, so now you're getting double the amount of credits for the same price. I encourage you to just check it out. I'll drop a link for you in the description underneath. And by the way, I'd love to hear your thoughts. Let me know in the comments underneath. And if you're new, welcome to the cafe. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications. You won't miss any of my tutorials and videos. So until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.